Guys, namaste, and I hope all of you are doing great. Let's talk about Sandhi and Gandanta. What is it all about? I'm sure many of you out there are sort of confused. What is it? Some people are really fearful of this Gandanta and Sandhi points. So I hope to demystify the concepts here. All right, so let's start from the top. Sandhi means a confluence or a communion of two opposing energies. Okay, now to understand that, you need to know that every component in Jyotish has an energy associated to it. This energy is elemental, you know, it's very the properties are very elemental properties, elementary properties. As such, you can do more research about this. You can do a search on Google for Prakriti, the Trigunas, or simply Tattva, you know, the principles or in astrology. So these elemental energies, if they come together, either it has an opposing side or it has a positive one. All right, Sandhi is the inauspicious, the negative one. All right, so what are the types of components? Now, before that, what happens if it's in a Sandhi? Right, now we know that if it's coming, if it's a malefic confluence, if it's a malefic communion, a bad get together, then it causes Sandhi. But what does it do? Right? A Sandhi makes a person go inwards. A person will get really some kind of a spiritual, dwell in spirituality mainly. It's sort of a time of awakening. Now, why is that bad? Isn't that good? I mean, if you're into spirituality, if you think about spirituality, I mean, it sounds very counterintuitive, isn't it? But the thing is, it makes a person only do that, right? So he or she would be, will be out, will be the, beyond the ambit of his or her day-to-day responsibilities, all right? Because they'd be focused in all these spiritual thoughts, you know, profound things, the genesis of creation, who's God, why am I here, and all these questions would be raised. As such, one would be hindered with their responsibilities, you know, your social obligation would not be there, and so you lose everything eventually, because we need to work, we need to pay bills, we need to feed, as you know, we need to study, we need to do things, isn't it? It's a very karmic approach in life. This one is kriya, you know, it's a very inward thing. It's good for people who are in that spiritual lines, you know, sandhis are actually good in that sense. But then for the majority of us, you know, going inward, only thinking about spiritual things, getting confused about it, that's the key word here, getting confused about it is bad. So now we know Sandhi means a bad coming together, and it is a it makes a person confused and become a recluse, a social recluse. You know, he or she will be spending most of the time in the room locked up, thinking about all these profound things, all right? So types of sandhis, right? Rasi sandhi, right? Now Rasi sandhi is at the end of the Rasi, the 12 minutes. That's 0.3 degrees at the end of the Rasi, and at the beginning of the following Rasi, another 12 minutes or 0.3 degrees. These two junction, I mean, this period in between is called the sandhi. So if you have a graha transiting that gap, right, then that graha is basically going through sandhi, right? That's Rasi. Next is Tidhi sandhi. So Tidhi is basically, as you know, is the lunar phases, the phase of the moon, the shape of the moon. So you have 14 on the brighter side, Shukla Paksha, and 14 on the darker side, 14 or fourth night on the darker side, which is called Krishna Paksha. And in between these two, you have the Paurnami and Amavasya. So altogether, 14, 14 plus 2, that's 13, 30 days. Okay. So the Sandhi happens in primarily, all right, primarily at the Shukla Pratipada, the first Tidhi after the waxing phase. Okay. The in between time, the ending and the beginning of the first lunar day is a Tidhi, Sandhi. But it's also accepted if you look at your chart, if you open up your chart in your software there, you'll see the TD of your birth, right? At the and there you will see that it has a percentage associated to it. It says that Okay, another 25%, and you'll go to the next city, or you have another 46% before it goes to the next city, or so on and so forth. If you have 5% and below, all right, before it goes to the following city, then that is a Didi Sandhi. What else? You have the Gandanta. Okay, now Gandanta is a double Sandhi, okay, which is pretty dangerous. It makes a person go very eccentric, very. Sometimes even you know, a total I mean, be seen as a total loser, because he or she would be only thinking about it, only talking about spirituality and concepts and strange things that we would not be even thinking, you know. They'll be seen as weirdos, all right? But are they weird? No, they are just their mind is going inwards, right? They're trying to understand the very essence of who they are, right? So Gandantas are essentially a very confusing time. Right, two opposing energies are coming into in a very powerful, I would say, phase. Right, so what are the double sandhis happening here? So first is a Rasi Sandhi. Right, now this Rasi is specific to three particular Rasis, which is the Mesha, Simha, and also Dhanas. Okay, so these Mesha, Simha, and Dhanas, they are fiery signs. Now, adjacent to them, right, you have the Mina, Karkataka, and also Vrichika, which are watery signs. So, fire and water, they are opposing. You know, they are against the tattvas. You know, it's totally out of the window. And that means that it's a special sandhi, which is called a Gandanta. Now, not only that, there are specific nakshatras. That, of course, you can, I mean, there's a chart for it. You need to know which particular nakshatra, which particular pada is happening, like the Mula and Revati and so on. I have given a reference below. You can check, click on the link, and you will see the chart there, so you will know exactly. I'm not going into details, right? So, but just know that a Gandanta is a special double sandhi, all right, which is pretty bad. What else? Dasa Sandhi, right? Dasa Sandhi is only used for marriage. So people come to me and say they want to get married to look for an auspicious time. So we use electional astrology, Muhurta. One of the many things that I check is Dasa Sandhi. Dasa Sandhi is at the end of the Dasa of the groom and the beginning of the Dasa of the bride, or vice versa, Antar Dasa, Dasa Bhakti, and so on. And if it's between 12 minutes or, you know, 0.3 degree changes distance, that would be a Dasa Didi, Dasa Sandhi, right? So as you can see, there are different types of sandhis, okay? And it can be confusing only if you put on to practice, and then you eventually will get a good grasp of it. But just know that sandhi is a malefic confluence of a specific elemental properties, okay? Now, here's an interesting part. For most people are unaware that there is a positive sandhi, which means when they come together, they come in a very auspicious way, which is called a Sangama, or in Tamil it's called a Sangamam. Okay, it's rarely seen. I don't think many talk about this Sangama or Sangamam, but there are positive sandhis as well. They're called a Sangama, and it's a great time, this positive Sangamas. Okay, you can also do some research of you. If you really need me to do a video on that, do let me know. I'll see if I can work on that as well. But so that's about Sandhi and Gandanta. Hope this video is beneficial for you. Until next time, thanks guys, and stay tuned.